Of course, the next question will be, and which are those vowels? So now we're going to start here from the right to the left. Now, on the ventilation panel, we're going to start with the extract valve. So the first valve will be, we're going to close the extract valve. The blower valve, you're going to change it for inlet. So we're going to close the extract valve. We're going to close the inlet valve. Then we're going to continue here with the ram air valve, continuing with the pack flow control valve and the main outflow valve.
All right, now as Juan mentioned, five valves, and I want you to take a look at this picture and look at the outline, and what do you see on the outline? Okay, I'll give you a second to look at it. Take a look at the image. What do you see on the outline of these five valves? If you guessed ship or boat, you are correct. So what you're gonna do, again, is make this aircraft a ship. You're gonna ditch the airplane. You wanna make it possible for it to float, obviously, right? So we're gonna seal the vessel, and in doing so, we're gonna allow this thing to float just like a ship. So what does the ditching push button do? Closes the valves below the waterline, and there's, of course, follow-up questions always gonna be, what are the five valves? And you're gonna go ahead and give the five valves a response to that one. So we're gonna change it up now. I'm here alongside with my colleague, Juan. I'm gonna be the examiner, he's the student. I'm gonna give him the questions, and we're gonna have him answer. All right, so the first one, we're moving up to the hydraulics panel, okay? So on the hydraulics panel, this is one of my favorite systems right here, and lots of questions that can come out of here. So here's the first one for you, Juan, as you go for your type rating here, right? Here's the first question they're gonna ask you on your oral. Typically, it starts with the engine-driven pump, okay? I wanna keep something in mind, right? When we're talking about hydraulics, we got three systems, green, yellow, blue, okay, they're all operating at how much PSI, right? Typically, it's the first question, nice warm-up, nice and easy.
3,000
PSI. There you PSI. Go. Okay, 3,000 PSI. And of course, as we get going now, we're going to talk about amber fault lights, and we're going to talk autologic. So let's talk about this green, specifically engine-driven pump, which, by the way, the response we're going to give you right now for this green engine pump, this fault light, is pretty much the same for the yellow as well. So with the engine-driven fault light, okay, this pump fault light, what does that amber fault light indicate? What does that mean?
Well, now remember from the system review, if the engine-driven amber fault light comes on, it's going to give us the first three answers. It's going to be reservoir. So it's going to be reservoir low quantity, reservoir low pressure, or reservoir overheat. And the last one will be pump pressure low, or the output of the pump pressure is low.
So there you go, a good way to keep that in mind. Remember, three of those responses have to do with the reservoir. So always start out with reservoir for the first three, right? Whether it be low quantity, overheat, or pressure, all of them associated with the reservoir. And then that fourth and final one there is going to be, of course, the pump output pressure happens to be low.